What's going on, everyone? Hope you have a great day. So here I'm back on another video. I'm Surjit and welcome to my channel. And today in this video I'm going to show you another test about the dual coin mining on Dynex and Radiant. So as you know that Dynex and Radiant is going to be a top and it's going to be a popular Dynex right now. And for the profitability, here you can see that on 3060 card the Dynex is going a top and it's continuously showing that Dynex is going a top and there is some max profitability some others coin. So on this second option here you can see that Dynex and Radiant is some kind of get some profitability in there. So that's why I choose the Dynex and Radiant as a test that how much it can take, and there is showing that the 0.03 cents profitability after the electricity. But if you are mine Dynex as a single coin mining, so you get some 0.07%. and however on the what to mine, here you can see that the current profit and current values, I select 3060 one card and that is the profitability is shows the 0.4. and right now I'm going to the price that how what is the price of Dynex, that you can see that on coin market cap 0.21 cents, and one day profitability is right now 3.43%. and on Dynex there is the less profitability, there is no profitability today, and one day it's 4.22% minus. and today I'm going to use for the dual coin mining as the Dynex and Radiant. So I'm going to use the 10 miner 1.1.3, the latest version for the Dynex, because SRB miners is going to be a crashing issue, a malloc registration error and something a security error, all kind of issues I'm facing right now. So that's why I'm using 10 miner version 1.1.3. however, 10 miner is not available on HiveOS, so I'm using the custom URL to install the 10 miner in HiveOS. And for the Radiant I'm using the BZ miner, because Radiant, if you are using the BZ miner for mining the Radiant, so you get the maximum hash rate. So I'm going to use the BZ miner for the Radiant. And for the miner pool, I'm going to echo pool server for the Dynex, and I'm going to use the sg.echopool.com. before, in this others video I am using the us.echopool.com, and this is going to be a great, but right now there is some issue. So right now I'm using the sg.echopool.com. and for Radiant I'm using the viper.net, and this is the overclock setting for the dual coin mining. You can check it out in there on hashrate.no, but right now today I am using some other settings. You can see that there is some is core clock offset is 250 and core locked core clock is 1500 and memory clock is 5000 and power limit is 180. But I am using the different flight sheet or the different overclock setting in there. So let's back to my HiveOS account, and here we can see that I'm using the or the testing on my cards per card, and here you can see my one card is showing in here, and I'm not using any overclock setting in the right in there. I'm just click on the auto fan speed option and just save on that. There is no overclock setting. I'm going to use the direct on my cards. So all the overclock setting and the other setting I'm using on my flight sheet. So how to mine or how to create the flight sheet? First of all, I'm going to use the or show that the wallet. Okay, so in this here you can see that this is my Dynex web wallet. So just click on that and select the Dynex coin and select your wallet address, and I'm using the Dynex web wallet in there. So just paste in and update your wallet. And for the Radiant, I'm using this the same process. So I'm going to right now on the flight sheet. So on flight sheet in there, just click on the edit. One more thing is that on the Radiant here you can see that I get the same hash rate when I start the mining and the stop my mining. There is no dropping. It's some kind of 186.5 to 6. or 3 mega hash I get, and on Dynex when I start I get around 816 hash rate, but on after some time it's dropping, it's around 768 to 771 or 73. Let's back to the flight sheet. So on flight sheet, in there just I click on the edit option, and I'm not choosing the BZ miner on the first option, so I'm using the Dynex or 10 miner at the first option. So just I select the Dynex first coin, Dynex web wallet, configure in miner and choose the custom. And on custom settings I choose the custom URL and paste on there, and for the default it shows the 10 miner and Dynex solve. I select the wallet, and on there just dot worker name is delete, and copy on that worker name and paste on your password section. And I'm choosing the echo pool server, so that's why I paste on the this server address or the pool address. And this is my the extra configure section, that extra config argument, that the chip's memory is 00. So I'm deleted one because today I'm testing on the number one card, so I'm using the 0. And malloc endpoint https dns sgakapool.com, and core clocks is 1545, memory clocks is 5001, and core offset is 300. And this is going to be a grade, and apply on changes and create on update. So this is my flight sheet that I'm using, and this is for the 10 miner. And just add miner and choose the radiant for there, and select your wallet address, select viper.net, so I'm using viper.net in there. And just a minute, so I'm choosing viper.net and using the USA East, and choose on apply, select BZ miner, and on setup config file I'm not using any others extra config argument in this area. You can see that the default setting in there, so I just click on apply on changes and update on my flight sheet. So this is my overall flight sheet is there. Here we can see that the same settings in there that I choose and update on my flight sheet. And now I just run on my flight sheet. So here we can see that is running on my 3060 V1 card is running, and it's got around 771 hash rate. So as I mentioned you that when I starting it's showing that 816 hash rate, but after some time it decreases and it shows that 771 hash rate I got on Dynex. And in this here on the radiant, here we can see that I got around on the minus section is 186.58, but on pool I got around 177 mega hash. And here we can see that my 3060 V1 card is running, and this is the update in here. So on there, here we can see that it's my HiveOS account, and this is the I'm using the record my mobile screen, so that's why this is showing some kind of freaky. So here we can see that it's take around 52 watt, and I got around 768 to 186. And this is my rigs, and here you can see that is run on, and I got the same hash rate, that 771 mega hash or the hash rate in Dynex, and 186. And there is the auto fan speed option I just selected, and the on overclock setting I did not set any overclock setting. And this is my flight sheet, as you can see that I select or create my flight sheet, and this is it. So here we can see that there is the result, and my fan is now running on 80%, and Dynex is giving me 768, and on Radiant I got 186, and the power consumption is 52 watt. So this is the update in this video, that how to mine dual coin mine on Dynex and Radiant. And this is the Dynex main blockchain website, so you can launch their app. So this is it in this video. I hope you like this video, this informative video. So if you like this video, please like and subscribe to my channel and comment your opinion that which coin you are mining right now and what your opinion about the dual coin mining on Dynex and Radiant. So have a great day. See you in the next one.